A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 22nd October, on the front page you have peaceful but low polling in two states. So Maharashtra and Haryana saw legislative assembly elections, and the turnout in Maharashtra was 60% compared to 63% in 2014, and in Haryana 65% compared to 76% in 2014. And this is Infosys Brass accused of unethical practices. So whistleblowers have pointed the finger at the CEO himself. So this is Infosys, which is embroiled in another controversy after whistleblower group said the company was indulging in unethical practices to boost short-term revenues and profits. So this group, Ethical Employees, has complained to the US Securities and Exchange Commission and the board of directors of Infosys that CEO Salil Parekh and CFO Nilanjan Roy had asked the complainants not to fully recognize visa costs in the quarter and $50 million in contract reversals. Then this is new rules to regulate social media by January. So now the Ministry of Information Technology has said in an affidavit in the Supreme Court that rules to regulate social media intermediaries needed to be revised, and regulatory regime had to be revamped as such, ramped up, considering the ever-growing threats to individual rights and the nation's integrity, sovereignty and security. So new information technology intermediaries guidelines, that is amended rules, would be notified by Jan 15, 2020. Then this is can't conduct business out of palaces, says Puri. So this is Hardeep Singh Puri, Minister of State, as such, on Housing and Urban Affairs. So this is again regarding Central Vista. So Central Vista is a plan to revamp the entire parliament, you know. So there are British-built buildings, you know, along the Rajpath too. So that entire stretch is called Central Vista. And again, another reason is being given. He says that these are old palaces which have been converted into government offices. So we can't conduct business out of palaces, which has been done for the last 70 years. So spending money on this huge infrastructural plan to revamp and modernize the Parliament House, North and South Blocks and Rashtrapati Bhavan. So that is here again a justification for the need is being made. On page 4, you have Supreme Court accepts Centre's revised land offer for Ravidas Temple. So this is regarding Ravidas Temple, which had been razed down, which had resulted in the Bahujan Samaj actually coming up in protests, and violent protests were witnessed after this. So now in the case is in the Supreme Court, and central government has offered land. So 400 square meter of land in Tughlakabad forest area would be provided for reconstruction of this Ravidas Temple. Means the location of the temple would be shifted. So this is the Supreme Court has accepted this land offer of the central government. On page 9, you have UP tops in crimes against women, says National Crime Records Bureau report. So incidents of atrocities against scheduled castes has also jumped from 5082 to 5775. So this is rate of total cognizable crimes per lakh of population is shown. Low crime is seen in Kerala, you can see. Then, this is Siachen now open for tourism. So, Siachen Glacier is now open for tourists, and tourism is what the Defense Minister has announced after inaugurating a strategically important bridge on Shyok River in eastern Ladakh. So, here you can see this is a setu called Colonel Chewang Rinchen Setu. It's an altitude of 14,650 feet. So the opening of this bridge, Setu means bridge, in eastern Ladakh is seen. And then below you have many hydropower projects could face closure. So minimum of supply of water has been mandated for hydropower projects, and in December 2019, it may be the case that hydropower projects do not comply with Centre's ecological flow notification, which mandates that project developers ensure a minimum supply of water all through the year, could face closure. So hydropower projects are the one through which water of rivers can be harnessed for clean energy. But here you can see, if minimum flow is not maintained, government may close these hydropower projects. On editorial page, you have the first editorial, no surprise in store. So this is regarding the elections, the legislative assembly elections. It says a tired opposition was no match to the hyper nationalism of BJP in the poll campaign in Maharashtra and Haryana. And this is safe but not entirely. So this is regarding presence of aflatoxin M1 in milk, which points to the need for to regulate cattle fodder. So the results which have come from FSSAI inspection, the survey which it conducted. So this it says it is in some way it is safety is there, but it's not entirely safe, and there's a need to regulate cattle fodder too, which affects the milk. The lead article, Asia's remarkable economic transformation. So this is regarding how government played a vital role, ranging from leader to catalyst or supporter in Asia's half century of development. So Asian governments played a role here. And below you have a fix for growth gain from fiscal pain. So this is regarding the corporate tax cut, you know, the euphoria behind it fading. It says government needs to address issues fundamental to the economy now. So some recommendations are also listed down here, like on micro, small and medium enterprises. Even yesterday we saw regarding Mr. Banerjee giving his viewpoint, Nobel Prize winner Abhijit Banerjee, on how, you know, the economy can be revived through putting money in the hands of the poor, through PM Kisan, NREGS schemes. On upper page you have GDP is a means, not an end. So it says it is a way to create jobs, but ultimate aim should be to raise the quality of life of the poorest people. So this is an article by Mr. Abhijit Banerjee himself and his wife, Esther Duflo, both Nobel laureates for 2019 in economics. And this is a roadmap for criminal justice reforms. So amendments to laws must be based on certain principles. So this is regarding the announcement that Home Minister said that IPC and CRPC should be modified, amended. So it should be based on certain principles is what this article argues. And this is China's growing clout at the UN. So China is actively seeking to use the UN platform to legitimize and spread its ideology. So that is an article here. On page 12, you have Kartarpur MOU to be signed tomorrow. So New Delhi has asked Islamabad, that is India has asked Pakistan, to reconsider its demand for a $20 service fee from each pilgrim. So an MOU on this is expected to be signed on October 23, the opening of the Kartarpur corridor, which we have discussed quite often. You should know about it by now. Then on international page, you have US is quietly reducing its troops in Afghanistan. So size of the American force in Afghanistan has dropped by 2,000 over the last year, down to roughly 12,000 now. So how US is already reducing the size of its forces, troop forces here, is evident. It has already left Syria. And this is Pentagon chief now saying that US will keep some troops in Syria. So this is to prevent Islamic State from controlling oil in the region. Then again, Brexit deal is still hanging. Prime Minister Johnson pushed for Brexit deal vote, but it was blocked. House of Commons Speaker refused to allow voting, saying the motion is in substance the same as the earlier motion which had called for extension of the date. And this is Australian newspapers redact front pages to protest curbs. So media industry has united against laws that restrict press freedom in Australia, and they have brought out these front pages appearing heavily redacted. So this is protest against the legislation that restricts press freedom. It's a rare show of unity by usually partisan media industry. Then this is continuation of the front page news. Infosys CEO accused of unethical practices. So that is detailed out here, what we saw on the front page too. It said several $1 billion deal in last few quarters had nil margin. So these unethical practices, unfair means which are being used, to boost profit is coming forth now. Then this is avoid oil imports from Malaysia, trade body. So advisory follows Prime Minister's JNK remarks. So Union government has strongly objected to Malaysia's unprovoked remarks and criticism on India's move to abrogate Article 317 Jammu and Kashmir. So India's apex oil trade body, Solvent Extractors Association of India, has advised all its members to avoid imports from the Southeast Asian nation, Malaysia, because of prevailing tensions between the two countries. Then this is NBFCs raised 2.36 lakh crore in 1 year via loan sale. So this reflects choking up of traditional finance channels, is what Indian Credit Rating Agency says. So NBFCs are witnessing a crisis of confidence. So some players are defaulting on repayments. So this has raised a whopping 2.36 lakh crore in the last 12 months by selling loans. Then this is total wealth in India touches 12.6 trillion. So India is now fifth globally in terms of number of ultra high net worth individuals. So that is it. Then the last page does not have any news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com, which will be up and working today. Thank you.